Hey everyone, welcome to another, my second, well, third technically painting video. My first one was technically the cockatoo tokens, but I don't really count that. I'm going to show you how I paint my Star Destroyers. The first video that I did was with that random paint scheme that I had in my mind where I tried to make it look like Tron, but it didn't really work. And then this is my new paint scheme, which looks a hell of a lot better and makes Star Destroyers look very Sithy. So I'm going to show you how to do this with one that I've spray painted earlier. So I'm going to take this to being this. What I start off with straight away is a technique called dry brushing. Most painters out there know exactly what dry brushing is, but for those who don't, you take a bit of paint on your brush and then wipe next to nearly all the excess paint off the brush and then wipe it over the surface, so you get a very small amount of the paint on the area that you wish to colour, and then it won't be pure silver in this case, it'll just be a brushed effect, and then you keep doing that all the way around and eventually it'll look like my other one does on the sides with just a little bit of silver. Is my phone focusing there? No, it's not. There you go. Can you see that on the sides? This makes the walls of the Star Destroyer pop out nicely. So I'm going to carry on and do all the sides and the guns of this Star Destroyer now. Anyway, here we go. Don't worry about going over the sides either, because you can just go over that with a bit of black paint later on. Oh, and by the way, if you are going to do the dry brushing technique like I am, use an old paintbrush that you don't care about anymore, otherwise the tip of the brush will be buggered and it'll be a brand new paintbrush that you want to use for fine detail and you won't be able to anymore. So make sure you use an old brush, because it will get completely buggered. Okay, so I've done all of the main bits that I needed to dry brush. I've done all the guns, I've done the bridge, I've done the back. Well, not the engines yet, because obviously I need to paint those first, and then I'll dry brush over them afterwards. Otherwise, there's no point. A bit of detail underneath there as well, just like my other one. So what I'm going to do now is do the same technique on my second gladiator that I've also spray painted. So I'm going to dry brush all that in exactly the same way along all the walls and the guns and the bridge, and a bit of the engine bay as well. There we go, all done. Guns are highlighted, bridge is highlighted, and the walls are highlighted. What next? Suppose I should do the lights now, / windows, and then after that I'll do the engines. So I need a different colour now. I'll go for green first. That one, to be exact. Whoops. Went over a little bit on that one. I'm going to carry on doing this now, and I'm going to do the same with this Temple Guard blue as well, to highlight blue windows too. So let's fast forward to when I've done that on both this and the Gladiator. Okay, that's the green and blue lights done on the top and the bottom and the sides. I have gone over in some places, but I'll be cleaning it up with some black afterwards, because all the dry brushing is still all over the place. I've done the same on the Gladiator as well. There's my Gladiator with the highlights and the blue windows, hangar bay on the front. Looks like he's put lipstick on badly, but again, I'll neaten that up later. What I'm going to do now is the silver highlights before I need to knit up with the black, and then I'll do the engines. So let's do some detailing. Okay, now that the details are done on both of them, I'm going to start on the engines. I'm going to do the Victory Class ones first because they're bigger and easier to do. Let me just move these paints out of the way because we don't need them for the moment. What I do need is white. So what I'm going to do is start with white, completely cover the inside of the engines with white, and then we'll layer it up like I did with my other ones with orange and red dry brushing. Okay, that's both of those Star Destroyers done. They need to be left to dry before I start dry brushing in with the orange and then the red. Otherwise, the orange will just mix in with the white paint and it won't have as nice of an effect. So, whilst it dries, I'm going to walk the dog. Hector? Come here. Sit. We're gonna go for a walk. Yeah, let's go for a walk then. Let's go. That's a bit deep for you, Hector. Right, now that the white's dried, we're gonna do some of the orange dry brushing. So the same technique as we used with the silver earlier. Okay, time to do the red dry brushing. Alright, so that's the silver detailing done. I think that's everything to do with detailing. I might come across something as I neaten it up with the black paint, but I think we're done. So I'm just going to get some black paint on my fine detail brush, and we're just going to very carefully go over the areas that I accidentally got paint on whilst dry brushing and things, like right there in the top corner. I'm going to go over it with some black. And there we have it, guys. My four Star Destroyers are fully painted and complete. Got my two Gladiators as twins, almost identical twins. Obviously, I do the lights a little bit different. And then we've got my Star Destroyers as well. I don't know which one's my new one. I actually don't know which one's my new one now because they look so similar. Which one is it? I don't know, but they both look pretty awesome. I think this one's my new one that I've painted. So, yeah. That's it for painting my Star Destroyers, guys. Let me know what you think of this paint scheme. I think it looks pretty Sithy. Bit more evil, bit more Empire-like instead of just being on the grayscale. My next video, I think I'm going to... whoa, we're going a little bit dark there. There we go. Let's brighten things up a bit, then you can see it. There we go. You can see them now. So on my next video, what I think I'm going to do is take one of the Victory classes, probably this one, because it's my first one that I've painted and it's a little bit neater. I'm going to do a Royal Guard scheme. I'm going to use some masking tape and do some red stripes across it, make it look a bit more royal for like when the Empire, from when the Emperor visits. I might do the same one on my Gladiators, just to show some rank. So that's it for now, guys. I will see you in the next video.